Hi dear children, hope all of you are fine, hope you are all happy. You learned the story, The Happiness Machine, right? Did you enjoy that story? Could the machine create happiness? Could it make people laugh by forgetting all their worries? The machine recreated all the beautiful scenes of the world, made the air fragrant and temperature fine. But it couldn't make anyone happy. Can you say why? Happiness is something that you feel from within. Have a look at this. Nature provides us everything to make us happy, right? We have to find happiness from it. Can't the singing birds, rustling leaves, flowing stream, fragrant flowers make us happy? Yes. Can't the fulfillment of our wishes make us happy, children? Will we be happy if all our wishes are fulfilled? Yes, but we have to work hard for it. We often pray for our wishes to be granted. Who do you often pray for? For good marks in exams? For something you long for? Here, we have a wonderful prayer by the famous American poet Robert Frost. He is famous for his realistic depiction of the rural life of America. Let's go through the profile of Robert Frost. Robert Frost, the most widely admired and highly honored American poet of the 20th century, was born on 26 March 1874 in San Francisco, California. He was famous for his realistic characterization of rural life and his command of American colloquial speech. Frost was honored frequently during his lifetime, and he is the only poet to receive 4 Pulitzer Prizes for poetry and was nominated for the Nobel Prize in Literature 31 times. Frost was named Poet Laureate of Vermont. He was awarded the Congressional Gold Medal in 1960 for his poetic works. Robert Frost defined poetry as a momentary stay
against confusion. His major works are After Apple Picking, Mending Wall, The Death of a Hired Man, Birches, The Road Not Taken, The Oven Bird, Stopping by Woods on a Snowy Evening, etc. Other than poems, he wrote some plays also. He passed away on 29th January 1963 at the age of 88.
We are going to learn a beautiful poem by Robert Frost. Name of the poem is A Prayer in Spring. Let's go through it.
A Prayer in Spring by Robert Frost. Oh, give us pleasure in the flowers today, and give us not to think so far away, as the uncertain harvest keep us here, all simply in the springing of the year. Oh, give us pleasure in the orchard white, like nothing else by day, like ghosts by night, and make us happy in the happy bees, the swarm dilating round the perfect trees. And make us happy in the darting bird, that suddenly bow the bees is heard. The meteor that thirsten with needle bill, and off a blossom in the mid-air stands still. For this is love, and nothing else is love, the which it is reserved for God above, to sanctify to what far ends he will, but which it only needs that we fulfill.
Dear children, did you enjoy the poem? What is the poem about? What does the poet plead? We saw, it's in the spring season, the poet is making such a prayer. Spring is a season of hope and optimism. We know that nature appears most beautiful and promising in the spring season. It's a time of cheerfulness, energy, and hope. Green leaves and flowers will appear in trees after the winter. Singing birds and busy bees fill the atmosphere with pleasure. Bhoomi ഏറ്റവും മനോഹരിയാകുന്നത് വസന്തത്തിലാണ്, അല്ലേ കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങളെ? പ്രകൃതിയുടെ ഉത്സവമാണ് വസന്തം. ഏതൊക്കെ ഭാഷകളിൽ എത്ര കവികളാണ് വസന്തത്തെ വാഴ്ത്തിപ്പാടിയിരിക്കുന്നത്! പാടങ്ങൾ പൊന്നിൻ നിറം പൂണ്ടു നീളെ, പാടിപ്പറന്നെത്തി തത്തയെല്ലാം, കേടറ്റ നെല്ലിൻ കതിർ കാമ്പു കൊത്തി, കൂടാർന്നതി കോർത്തു പോകുന്നു വാനിൽ. ചന്തം ധരക്കേറെയായി ശീതവും പോയി, അന്തിക്കു പൂങ്കാവിലാളേറെയായി, സന്തോഷമേറുന്നു ദേവാലയത്തിൽ, പൊന്തുന്നു വാദ്യങ്ങൾ വന്നു വസന്തം. മഹാകവി കുമാരനാശാന്റെ പൂക്കാലം എന്ന കവിതയിലെ വരികളാണിത്. All the living beings seem happy and enthusiastic in the spring season. Shall we go through the poem in detail?
A Prayer in Spring by Robert Frost. Oh, give us pleasure in the flowers today, and give us not to think so far away, as the uncertain harvest keep us here, all simply in the springing of the year.
Dear children, now it is your turn to read the poem. Read it.
Thank you.
Did you go through the lines? It's a prayer in the spring season, which is a time of rebirth, renewal, and awakening. Things are coming back to life in this season after the lethargic winter. Weather turns warm and pleasant. Flowers and trees bearing ripe fruits fill happiness around. Spring is considered to have the ability to cast away all our worries and disappointments. Whom does the poet address to? Yes, the poet addresses to the supreme power or God. Is the poet alone there? Yes, you are correct. The poet may be standing in a field and he may be in the company of his fellow farmers. What is he praying? He prays to God to give him pleasures in the flowers today. Look at the expression today. Why does he use the word in such a way? The poet is requesting pleasures in the present to give him the ability to attain happiness in the present moment. The poet is insisting not to bother about the future that is unreachable and unpredictable. Bhavi, eppozhum pravachanatheethamaanu, alle? Why does he refer harvest as uncertain? He requests God to help him concentrate on the present. Need not worry about the future harvest. Need not bother about the fruits. Just work in the present and be happy. Let's go through the next stanza. Go through the lines. Is there any difficult words? Where does the poet find happiness? Yes, the poet finds happiness in the orchard white and in the happy bees. The flowers of the orchard will become fruits, no matter whether he could harvest it or not. He is determined to find pleasure in this day. Why does the poet compare flowers to ghosts by night? Yes, the poet wishes to find happiness from the orchard with beautiful white flowers and the happy bees dilating around the trees. Did you notice a beautiful expression that the poet compares white flowers to ghosts in white apparel? You might have noticed that the flowers bloom at night are white in color. രാത്രിയിൽ വിരിയുന്ന മനോഹരമായ പുഷ്പങ്ങൾ, ആ വെളുത്ത പുഷ്പങ്ങളെ വെള്ളവസ്ത്രം ധരിച്ച പ്രേതാത്മാക്കളോടാണ് കവി ഉപമിച്ചിരിക്കുന്നത്. What is the figure of speech used here? Yes, it's a simile.
Dear children, look at these lines. Oh, give us pleasure in the orchard white, like nothing else by day, like ghosts by night. Here the poet compares the white orchard to something. With what he compares it? Yes, the poet says that the white orchard is like the ghost in night. Can you identify the word that the poet uses to make such a comparison? Yes, the word is like. The poet uses this word to compare flowers to ghosts. You know that? Here, the figure of speech is simile. Simile is the comparison of two things by using the words like or us.
Moments happiness instead of waiting for the uncertain harvest. The poet wishes to enjoy the beauty of the white flowers in the orchard. He wishes to be happy in the swarm of bees dilating around the trees.
Let's summarize the poem once again. The poet is standing in a field and he is speaking to his fellow farmers. The poet urges the supreme power to give him pleasure in the flowers of the day, instead of thinking about the uncertain harvest. The poet pleads to give him pleasure in the orchard white and the happy bees merrily dilating around the trees. Here, the poet wishes to be happy in the moment itself, instead of worrying about the future, which is unreachable and unpredictable.
Can you connect this prayer to your life and write a brief note on any such a wish? Any wish that you want to be fulfilled? Attempt it and send it to your English teacher. It is time to wind up. Till we meet in the next class, stay safe, stay happy. Thank you.